Stay tuned for the latest message excerpt from josephprince.com.
If I can choose one characteristic of Caleb, the man who never grew old. Remember the man, Caleb? 40 years old. He was among the spies that God sent into the land to spy out the land. He came out. He was full of faith. He said, let us go up at once and possess. The people didn't believe. They had to wander for 40 years. And Caleb wandered with them, you know, for 40 years. But his heart is always in Canaan. His heart is always in Beulah land, the land flowing in milk and honey. Though his body was in the wilderness with all the people, but his heart is in land. So even we are on earth, our heart, our minds is in heaven, where there is no lack, where there's no fatigue, where there is no disease, where there is no strife, where there's no bitterness, where there's no unrest. My spirit must be in heaven. Those that are planted in the house of the Lord shall flourish in the courts of God. Those, and they shall be fat and flourishing. And the Hebrew there, they shall always be green. Flourishing is green. They are full of sap. So even though we live, he that dwelleth in the secret place of the Most High in heaven, you live there, all right, shall abide under the shadow of the Almighty. Your shadow is on your ground. On earth, you're under his shadow. If you live there, you're under his protection. Amen. So learn. When you see all the strife around you, learn to rise in the spirit with eagle's wings. Go above and see and smell the fresh air in heaven and see Jesus glorified. See Jesus come, all shall be well. Amen. See Jesus far above all principality and power. If you have symptoms in your body, look at him and say, as you are free from every disease right now at the Father's right hand, so am I in this world. And see him smile at you. Learn to rise. And then you'll be very effective on earth. Don't believe that, you know, they're so heavenly minded, they're no earthly good. Whoever said that, all right, better. No one knows who said that, number one. Could be from hell. I don't know. I'll tell you something. If you're heavenly minded, only then you can be earthly good. Because somebody who brings the peace of heaven can bring peace to a strife, a situation of strife, because he's come from heaven. Do you understand? So I love to spend time with babies and little children because they are fresh from heaven. You learn that life is a joy. It's not an event, then you're joyful. Don't wait for an event, then you are happy. They are happy all the time. All right. And it's a lie. You collect what you do not deposit and reap what you do not sow. It's a very evil thing to say, which is, you know, we enjoy what we do not sow. Jesus suffered, he sowed at the cross. We enjoy what we do not sow. Gee, we are the ones enjoying. But the next statement is, it's like this. Out of your own mouth, I will judge you. You call me austere. You call me exacting. Out of your own mouth, you will see me exacting. All right? So that is the thing that people must understand. If they see a God like that, they seem to only have that side of God manifesting, it seems. Okay? Are you all learning so far? Yeah. I was saying about the man who never grew old. How many want to learn how to not grow old? Yep. You want to learn how to not grow old? Okay. Yeah. All right? I thought you might not want. Okay. The number one characteristic. A lot of people say Caleb this, Caleb that. The number one characteristic of Caleb is this, okay? Numbers. God said, all these men who have seen my glory 10 times, they have not heeded my voice, they will not enter. They certainly shall not see the land. Next verse. But my servant Caleb, because he has a different spirit, and the word different spirit in the Hebrew is following spirit. He has a following spirit and has followed me fully. See the word followed me fully? We don't even talk about following the Lord. Fear of the Lord. We hardly even talk about following the Lord. Sheep follow the Lord. The Lord is my shepherd, I shall not want. Right? Sheep follow the Lord. Are you listening, people? When you follow him, you will not want. Jesus said, follow me a lot. He says, follow me and I'll make you fishers of men. Take up your cross and follow me. Amen? He told the rich young man, sell all you have and follow me. He said, follow me to the fishermen. Now, we don't even say that. We don't even teach that. It's about, fear the Lord. And actually, it's the wrong kind of fear. Well, following was a Caleb's secret. He not only followed, he followed fully. All right, next. Surely none of the men who came up from Egypt will see the land except Caleb. Oh, sorry, because they have not, last part of verse 11, because they have not wholly followed me. Except Caleb, Joshua, they have wholly followed the Lord. People, this emphasis I'm showing you is to show you how God emphasizes things that we don't even preach. wholly followed. Okay? Wholly followed. Okay, next. Many years came and gone. All right? Many years. This is now Joshua now. Joshua, about 40 years, 39 years have come and gone. And Joshua and Caleb are the only survivors. Those that came out of Egypt, all the men died. None of them went through the River Jordan into the Promised Land except Joshua and Caleb. Even Moses died. Aaron died. Only Joshua and Caleb. And finally, good old Joshua and Caleb. And Caleb says this, you know, Joshua, 40 years old was I when Moses sent me to spy out the land. And 45 years have come and gone. And he said this. He said, I'm as strong this day as Moses was. I'm as strong this day as I was when Moses sent me. And he's not lying. Then he says, give me this mountain. So you see what he says here? My brethren made the heart of the people melt, but I wholly followed the Lord. Now he's 85 years old talking. Still strong, he said. Drop down. Hebron therefore became the inheritance of Caleb, the son of Jephunneh the Kenizzite to this day, because he wholly followed the Lord God of Israel. Do you see that? At 85, he drove out the sons of Anak from that hill. The hill, by the way, if you go to Israel, is near Machpelah. You can still see the hill, all right? That hill was where the giants were. He drove them out at 85 years old. And the reason is because he wholly followed the Lord. How many want to wholly follow the Lord? All right, John 21. Then Peter turning around, after the breakfast, Jesus made breakfast. Jesus has risen from the dead about 2 weeks now. Peter turned around, saw the disciple whom Jesus loved. Who is that? John, following. What's John doing? Following. John was already following, who also had leaned on his breast at the supper and said, Lord, who is the one who betrays you? Same John, okay? Peter, seeing John, said to Jesus, but Lord, what about this man? Jesus said to Peter, if I will that he remain till I come, what is that to you? You follow me. You follow me. John practiced the Lord's love. He was conscious of the Lord's love for him. Therefore, he was conscious of the Lord's love for him. Therefore, he was following. But he was following unconsciously. One more time. When you're conscious of the Lord's love for you, you are following already. But Peter, who always boasts of his love for the Lord, had to be told, you follow me. Wow. Pastor Prince, why don't you teach your church more some imperatives? Because my people are following. Maybe you have to do for yours, but my people are following. You understand? The secret. John didn't have to be told to follow him. In fact, the mood there is not imperative. It's his following. He's following. It's a fact. But when Peter says, what about him? He says, what is that to you? You follow me. The mood there in the Greek is imperative. It's a command. You follow me. And friend, sometimes the Lord speaks to me. I look at what this person is doing, what this minister is saying, what that kind of thing. And God had to rebuke me with this verse many times, many times. What is that to you? You follow me. Sometimes I forget how much the Lord loves me and I get into the, I had to be told, you follow me. Don't care about what this person is doing, what that person is saying. You follow me. Amen. Ministers, leaders, stop looking horizontally and blaming people, finding fault. What about this person? Amen. It's never what about me. It's always what about this person. You follow Jesus. You follow Jesus. You do what he tells you to do. But those who practice his love, they're always following. Amen. May that be true for you as well.
This excerpt is brought to you by josephprince.com. To get the full message, visit josephprince.com.
By grace you meditate, and when you meditate, it brings more grace. Gives you influence. Grace gives you fruitfulness like Sarah. Grace gives you favor like Esther. Grace gives you good success. Grace gave us Jesus.
And how do we get this grace transported from heaven into our very souls, into our lives, into our bodies, into our minds, into our families, into our relationships?
Meditate.
It takes grace to meditate. But when by grace you meditate, it transports more grace.